Hello everyone, my name is Vikal Jain and today I am going to show you how to make prepared cost allocation MIS in Excel. So here what we are going to do, we are going to distribute our prepared cost on monthly basis. For example, if the product start date is 1st April 2021 and end date is 14th June 2021, then we are going to distribute this cost in April, May and June. You may clearly see here we have already written the days, but we are going to make this in Excel. So let's begin. So let's delete this. Now we need to find out the number of days so that we can distribute this cost. Now we are going to find out the daily cost. So daily cost, or you can say it as per day cost. So my per day cost would be this one divided by end date minus start date plus one. Why I am adding one in it? Because if I will subtract start date from the end date, it will reduce this day also. But I don't want to remove this day, so that's why I am adding one. Okay. Now here it is. Per day cost is this. Now we can drag and drop, and you can see per day cost is this one. Now we are going to find out the number of days. For this we are going to use if function. If you are using older version than Office 365, then you may use if function. So ifs. Now we are going to check whether this date is greater than this one. Now since this date is greater than this one, so what we want 1st April 2021. So what we are going to do, we are going to use max function. So and how we will calculate the 1st April 2021 by using end of the month and EO month. So it denotes end of the month and start date is this one, comma, minus one. Now if I will put minus one in it, it will take me to the earlier month. It means 31st March 2021. If I will add simply one in it, and it will show me 1st April 2021. So let me evaluate this by pressing F9 key. I have not closed the parentheses. Now let's evaluate F9. So it is showing me the number, and this number denotes the date. Control Z. You may check the format by using text function. I'm just checking this comma. So DD MM YYYY. Now close the parentheses. Now let's evaluate F9, and you can see it is showing 1st April 2021. So Control Z. Now I'm going to remove this text function. I have added this text function to show you the date format only. Now what would be the number 2? If this would not be greater than this one, then I want this date. So max will calculate the maximum of these two, and the answer would be here. Close the parentheses, and now we are going to check the second date, whether this date is greater than this one. Then what we want this date, and we need to use absolute and relative reference over here. So for F3 we are going to lock the row by pressing F4 key. I'm locking F4. Here it is. Now press enter, and now since this date is smaller than this one, so this is showing me the start date. If I will change this date to 1st May 2021, so and end date would be 30th May 2021. So it will cause an error because here we have both our condition false. So it will not show me the value. We will take care of this in by using if error function. And let's take the difference. So if this would be 1st March, now let's take the difference. What we are going to do, we are going to calculate the median of these three dates, 1, 2 and 3. So median, of this one, comma, this one, comma, and this one. Now what it is saying, please calculate the median. So median date would be 1st March, 30th May, and the mid date. These are three dates and the middle date is this. So here it is. Now use the general format. Now if this date would be 2nd April 2021, so the median date would be this and the median date this. So it is calculating the difference. Since it is again reducing the number 1 in it, so I am going to add number 1 in it and 1. Now again we are going to use the absolute and relative reference. In case of F3, I am going to use the row. In case of B4, I am going to log the column, and again column, and enter. Now we can drag and drop it. So we are going to change it to general and drag and drop, and here it is, and here it is. Now you will see here are some negative because this date has already gone here, so this is showing me negative. We can remove this negative by using if function. So what we are going to do, we are going to use the clipboard over here. So clipboard, I'm going to copy this formula into clipboard, copy. Now my formula is appearing here. Now I'm going to use if function. If this is less than 0, then what do you want? I want nothing. So 0, comma, I want this one, and enter. And you can see positive number is appearing here. Again drag and drop, and you can see all negative number has gone. Now we need to take care of this NAs also. So now we are going to use if error. And what do you want in case of error? I want 0, close the parentheses, and enter. Now let's drag and drop, and here it is. So we have calculated the number of days. We can close the clipboard. Now what we need to do, we need to just multiply the per day cost. So multiply this one and enter. So the per day cost is this. We can distribute it. We forgot to lock it, so we need to lock this E4 and enter. So let's drag and drop. And here it is. Let's check a scenario. Let's take this date from 1st April 2021 to 22, and the cost would be 3429, and here the total is 3429. So it means our answer is correct. So you can take this reference of MIS and distribute this prepared cost, and this template can save your lots of time. So you may download this template from the below link. So keep enjoying and keep learning.